In this video, we will cover building a harvest configuration and creating a harvest product. Building configurations and products are important as combine settings and calibrations are linked to them. This allows operators to switch between crop types and head types without having to recalibrate each time. The first step in creating a new harvest configuration is to tap the Setup app on the home screen. We need a new configuration, so on the Configuration tab, tap the Add button. Then select Harvest. The next screen asks you to select a vehicle. Since we do not currently have a combine entered into the display, tap the Add button. Let's create a configuration for one of the combines we just installed on, the New Holland CR9070. Select New Holland as the make and CR9070 as the model. Tap the blue Next arrow to proceed. The display now asks us for the vehicle name. It defaults to an abbreviation of the combine, make, and model, which is fine for this example. If you want to rename the vehicle, you can tap the keyboard button and enter a new name. Tap the green check mark to continue. Now we can enter offsets for our GPS antenna and the combine head. Tap the wrench to access the offsets page. Once on the vehicle offset screen, tapping the calculator in each field will allow us to change the value. Remember that these values are in inches. Once all of the antenna offsets have been entered, tap the Head tab to enter the head attachment point location. Once the attachment point location is entered, tap the green check, and then tap the Next arrow. Now we need to add our header. For this example, we will add a corn head. Tap the Add button and select Row Head for header type. Tap the Next arrow to continue. On the Rows and Spacing screen, it asks us to enter the number of rows and row spacing of our header. This machine is using an 8-row head on 30-inch spacing. After you've entered this, tap the Next arrow. Now we need to name the header. For row heads, the name defaults to the number of rows. Again, if you want to change the name, just tap the keyboard button. This name is fine for our example, so tap the green check mark to accept it. This returns us to the header screen. Tap the Next arrow to proceed. Now we must enter our speed source. Your primary speed source should always be set to display GPS if you have a GPS receiver connected. The backup source will be set to speed sensor module, and the auxiliary device will be wheels. You will also see the auxiliary channel calibration. This is the distance calibration that we'll cover in another video. It can be accessed once we've completed the configuration. We've entered all of the speed sources, so tap the Next arrow. Finally, we need to enter a name for the overall configuration. The display defaults to the combine name and header name. This can be changed by tapping the keyboard button. Once satisfied with the configuration name, tap the green check mark to accept. You will now be on the Setup page for your new configuration, where settings and calibrations can be adjusted. Tap the green check. Your combine header configuration is now added to the list under Harvest. Tap the back arrow in the upper left to return to the home screen. You are now ready to harvest. To begin harvesting, tap the Harvest app. Verify the correct configuration is selected and tap the Next arrow. Select the appropriate growing season, grower, farm, and field. If automatic variety tracking is being used, the growing season must match the growing season the planting data was recorded under. Tap the Next arrow. Select an existing product or create new. We will create a new product by tapping the green plus. Select the appropriate crop type. We will use corn for this example, and then tap the next arrow. The next screen will ask for crop name, which defaults to the crop type. For this example, we will leave it as corn. Tap the next arrow again. You can add planting varieties for tracking. If planting products were previously entered on this display, varieties with the same crop type will automatically populate this list. Tap the green check. After the product is created, it will bring you back to the product selection screen. Tap the next arrow. If planting data is available or needs to be imported, we can do that from this screen. If no planting data is present, a variety can be manually selected from the dropdown. Tap the green check. Now you are ready to begin the calibration processes. If you'd like to see more short tutorials from AgLeader, please subscribe to our channel.